Greetings. I won't be long. I just want to pass something that is needy for people to know and to understand. The mystery, the assignment, the responsibility, the duty which we on earth we're supposed to do as when God created heaven, he extended his kingdom to earth by creating earth also. Then when he created earth, God never include himself in rulership of the earth, but he trusted a human being. He trusted his baby, which is a man that is a human being. So God trusted me, trusted you, trusted everyone that lives on earth to rule earth according to how heaven is. That's why even when Jesus, the disciples in the book of Luke chapter 11, they asked him, Lord, teach us how to pray. Then Jesus told them on how to pray, a referral in Matthew chapter 6, when Jesus says, when you pray, you will say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So God trusted a human being, God trusted a man, God trusted a human being to rule the planet, which is the planet earth where we are, not to rule it outside of him. As we see worldwide, as we see in many secular world or in the world of modern days, people are ruling the nations, are ruling the countries without God. But being truthfully, the failure have been in the church. According to times, according to seasons of God, the church have misinterpreted or have mispositioned itself to an extent that even today the responsibility of the church has not yet been understood. So let me just paraphrase some few verses so that you may know that we have a responsibility, we have an assignment. Yeah, I know it's end times, but there's something that in the end times we are assigned to do. And as that thing has not been happened yet, we are going to see many wars in the world. Yeah, as we see worldwide or those countries who are trusted, whom we consider as a big countries, the Western world, fighting against each other. Yeah, like it's prophetic. Secondly, as it is prophetic, the Church of Jesus Christ worldwide supposed to understand why there are wars and what is the responsibility of the church thereof when there are wars in the world. When there is famine in the world, what is the responsibility of the church? When, to be specific, in South Africa, there is something that they call it's a protection fee. Protection fee, an evil thing that is being done in this nation by gangsters. Now, if there is something like that, the church has the responsibility to take it out of the nation. And really, saints, we can never rely upon on the politics, because politics are things of now. What is now? Politics, they started after 70 AD, during the time of Greek. They started there. Politics started there. Now, we can't rely on that. I will just read a scripture that is profeting about Jesus before he came on this physical world, which is on earth. That's Isaiah chapter 9. I will read from verse number 6. In this Bible of mine, ESV version, the heading says, "For us a child is born." That's Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder." Here is the responsibility. If we are in Jesus, if we have Christ in our hearts, one thing that we must not allow is the deception. Folks, the nations or the world is not supposed to be run by the politicians. No, that one, we must not interpret it. Jesus carried the government, because there is a difference between government and democracy. Government and democracy are two things that are different, which I need to be elaborated. And the church responsibility is to govern, is to govern, is to govern, is to control, is to rule, is to have dominion, is to own the world, is to own the earth of God, according to the scriptures, which are so referral, where God put a responsibility upon the children of the light. But when religion started to rise up through Roman Catholic, it has made sure that it sway or it mislead people, it put the church astray and separate the church from the governing authority, and permitted democracy to take over. What is democracy? Democracy is when one man want to rule the nation. By the explanation, democracy is the government, is the leadership of the people, by the people, and for the people. That means they ought to vote. Then when we speak about governing is what people are born with. Governing means the rulership. It's a rulership, it's an ownership. It's to rule. Now, Isaiah is saying, Jesus, the Son of Man, the Christ, the Son of God, carried in his shoulder the government. Let me read it. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. "And his name shall be called the Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end, on the throne of David, over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time forth and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this." So, one thing as the Church of Christ we must know, government is our responsibility. It is not a responsibility of someone who went to school to study on how to be a politician. No. Hear me well. Politicians are voted into power, but the church is not voted into power. Church is like Jesus on earth. No one who is a king who must go to school in order to learn on how to rule. But the Spirit of the Lord shall be upon that person. So the church responsibility is to govern. Let me read this responsibility in the New Testament. The responsibility of the church is to govern the earth. Inasmuch as the world is like this, but there is a responsibility for the church. And the church, if it's running away from the responsibility by coiling itself, pressing on, in hiding in between the walls, not going to influence the world, as Jesus said, you are the salt of the world, you are the light of the world, then that means the church does not know its own responsibility. All right, let me read Matthew chapter 24, first verse 14. Then I will proceed and go to last chapter of Matthew. Then verse 14 says, and this gospel of the kingdom will be proclaimed throughout the whole world. Listen to that. The whole world. As a testimony to all nations. Which is, there must be no a nation that is called an Arabic nation. There must be no a nation that is called a nation of atheists. A nation which we call the Buddhist nation. There must be no nation that is called a nation of Buntus, where people are worshipping idolatry. There must be no such. It's a responsibility, it's a command, it's not a plea. Jesus never plead, he never plead, it's a command. And this gospel of the kingdom will be proclaimed throughout the whole world as a testimony to all nations. And then the end will come. Jesus foretold us that the end will come when all these useless messages which are being proclaimed by many preachers, messages of prosperity, messages of giving people false hope, when they have ended, and the kingdom gospel, the good news of the kingdom, are started to be preached, then the end will come. Where all ministers of the Word of God have started to understand the concept of the Bible, to understand the concept of the kingdom, the concept of the kingdom, where the message that will be proclaimed will always make people to be attracted. They will be withdrawn close to the kingdom of heaven. Because there is only one message that Jesus preached. Secondly, Jesus said when he closed his chapter on earth, go Matthew 24 verse 14, the gospel of the kingdom, not the other round or not the other gospel which has been proclaimed. The gospel of the kingdom will be, which is, it's a must, it will happen, will be proclaimed throughout the whole world. Not in certain part of the world, but the whole world. And be testimony to all nations. Not to certain part. When you hear about Arabs, you won't go there. The gospel must invade such nations also. All right. That is the only sign of the end. Others are just a sign, as Jesus says, that don't be alarmed, the end is not yet. These are just birth pains. The sign of the end is when all preachers are preaching the gospel of the kingdom. Where they will not entice people, where they will not lie to people, where they will stand for the truth. Because the kingdom of heaven is the kingdom with truth. There is no enticement. There is no lies in the kingdom of heaven. There is no lies. The gospel of the kingdom, one, it shall begin with redemption. What is the redemption? Redemption is to call people to repentance. People must forsake their wicked ways. People must forsake their evil ways. In order for them to be restored in the kingdom of God, they must be redeemed first. And the redemption price was paid through the blood of Jesus Christ. So, preachers, prayer warriors, one thing we must cry about these days is the restoration to the church. One, the message. The church has lost the message. The church has lost the zeal to go out and challenge people. To go out and challenge people and witness about the kingdom of heaven. Right, let me read Matthew 28, verse number 18. My heading says, the Great Commission, so it's a great command. There's nothing that we can stand and say we are against this, because it's a command. It's a command that comes from our Master Jesus. Now, verse 18. And Jesus came and said to them, all authority, hold that, Jesus, who died for the whole world, who is the head of the church, that he gave all things to the church. He is claiming that all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to him. So, why does the church feel so threatened by the government? Are we afraid to be jailed? Are we afraid to be shot by the gangsters? Why are we so silent? Why there are drug lords in our nation who are not born in this nation? When Jesus proclaimed that all authority, not here only, in heaven. One thing that is lacking to this church generation that God is always crying about is the power of prayer. Because when we can understand the power of prayer, because let me just read a quick verse. I want you to understand this. Psalms 103. I will just read only one verse there. I'm not gone, Matthew. I'm still there. Psalms 103, verse number 19. Listen to this. The Bible says, the Lord has established his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom rules over all. Now, I say, when God had created heavens, he expanded, he extended his kingdom to earth. Then on earth, he put us, his royal family, as people who must take care of the earth. That's why the Bible, in the same Psalms, Psalms 115, verse number 16, it says, the heavens are for the Lord, and the earth, he has given it to the children of men. Who are those? Us. Then, the highest court is not the court in Pretoria, is not the court in New York, is not the International Justice Court. No, the highest court which the church must go is in heaven. Where the Bible, Isaiah 43, verse 26, in Good News version, it says, bring forth your case. Put me in judgment. God calling the church.
But the church understand not how to authorize prayer. It does not understand on how to walk in authority. Because one thing, saints, that God must help the church of our time is this: the zeal to pray. Not to pray as hidden. Matthew 6:24, Jesus is rebuking all these hidden prayers. Prayers of unbelievers, prayers of the Gentiles. He said in Matthew 6:33, but ye seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things that are your heart is hungry for will be added unto thee. Now, Jesus claimed that all authority in heaven, not in heaven only, also in earth, is given to him. He is the head of the church. He has given everything to the church. The church must use the authority to turn this generation upside down. How? Preach the kingdom. You stand on the streets, preach the kingdom. Challenge that we have is this. Many are born in a democratic world. And it's a pity that many are born in the colonized areas. I will just name few places here in South Africa. We have a place which is called Port Elizabeth, Ebay. It can be very, very hard for people who are born originally there to understand what is the kingdom. Why? Because the place is colonized. It's totally colonized by England. The whole South African nation is colonized by England. Therefore, it takes the grace of the Lord. It takes the mercy of the Lord to reveal the power of the kingdom. Then Jesus preached the kingdom. When he went to the grave, he raised up. Because Luke chapter 4, I believe it's verse 43, Jesus says, I have sent for preaching the kingdom, which is his death was the means for us to enter to be redeemed and to be restored, to be reconciled, to be born in the spirit, to be reconciled with God through the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Then he is saying, all authority in heaven, also where? On earth, is given to him. Didn't he die for the church? But why the church don't exercise his authority? It's because it's lacking prayer. It's lacking the genuity, the power of prayer. Where everything that is not permitted here on earth will be taken away. Jesus once spoke something. I will just read that verse because I've had many binding demons. I have had many binding things which are not supposed to be bounded. Let me read Matthew chapter 16, verse 19. The Bible says, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Not the door. The keys of the kingdom of heaven. Where is it given? To people of revelation. Saints, if the church supposed to reveal the mysteries, then keys of the kingdom of heaven is in the church. It is not in the politics. Politicians know nothing about ruling the world. They know nothing. That's why they do evil things. Church of Christ, rise up. Authority is given to you. Jesus told us,
that the authority in heaven, also on earth, is given to him. Now, let me continue reading. 19, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth. I love good news. Good news will say, whatever you prohibited, whatever you prohibited, where? On earth, will be prohibited also in heaven. Prohibited means that you don't permit it. You don't want it to happen. Where? On earth. Then also in heaven, there is a signature. Then it continues saying that, whatever you lose. Now, good news will say, whatever you allow, whatever you permit on earth, it is also permitted in heaven. So, Church of Jesus Christ, can whenever or wherever we are, have this zeal of taking this generation back to the fear of God. I know it's the end of times. I know it's the end times. And people are worried about being raptured. That's a good thing to worry about. But what about those who have never heard the gospel being preached? I am not coming here to bring controversy or whatsoever or arguments. No. The thing that I am raising is this. Nokuba, we can say tents are being pitched everywhere. But saints, let us speak the truth. Tents which are being pitched mostly are for fame thing. Because one thing that I know is this, one thing that is in the heart of God is to see people every day being saved, coming to the knowledge of truth, coming to know Christ, coming to know the kingdom of God. Now, as tents are being pitched, I would love us if we can ask ourselves, where did we miss it? Because somewhere, somehow, there is a place where we have missed it. As the responsibility of people to be saved depends upon us who believe in Christ, we have to sometimes ask ourselves why people are not repenting. Are we preaching the right message to them? Are we praying the right prayers for them? If not, then there is Holy Spirit who can help us. Because the Bible says he will lead us to all the truth, nothing else, to all the truth. If now we are saying that people are not coming to Christ because they are stubborn. No, saints, that's a lie. That's a lie. That's a lie. We need to ask to examine ourselves. We need to search ourselves to do introspection, personal introspection. That are we doing it on the right way? Is the message that Christ said we must preach, is it right? Are prayers which we are doing, are the prayers that can make heaven to pay attention on earth? Because one thing which I know or I understand according to the scripture is this. God, in everything that is on earth, his desire, his only desire, is to win as many hearts of people is concerned. The Bible, Matthew 25, verse 34, says, Jesus claimed this. The kingdom of God that was prepared for us before the foundation of the earth. It was not prepared for, hell was not prepared for anyone. Then laziness, especially in deepness of prayer, where we will ascend in the spirit, where we will call upon the name of the Lord,
Because what we say is revival, it begins about oneself. Who will break his or her own heart, crying out in repenting? Because the Bible says, 2 Chronicles chapter number 7, verse 14, God is putting this as a condition, because God can never save this generation until one says, Lord, here am I. Let me pay the price for my generation. And there is only one price, which is the one that God says to Solomon. If my people, one, if my people, he claimed them to be his, who are called by my name, those who are blood washed by the blood of Jesus, can one humble themselves? Now, to humble, saints, it's one thing that I wish we can have an understanding. King James Version, Psalms 35, verse number 13, it says, I humbled my soul with fasting. So, humble means that one must undergo a fasting. If my people who are called by my name can humble themselves, praying and seek me and forsake, which is turn away from their wicked ways, the Bible says, I, the Lord, will hear from heaven. I will heal their land. If this generation is a generation of warmonger, is a generation of drug lords, is a generation of alcohol, is a generation of sexual immorality, is a generation of witchcraft, then obviously we as the church, we need to rise up. We need to understand the parameters of the scripture to know and understand what is the kingdom all about. Because saints, one thing is this. According to the time, kingdom is a time for the kingdom. Now, God made the earthly kingdom. Then when Lucifer fall, who is now Satan, on earth, he also tried to form his and use the people, as well as God is using the people. Then what is happening is this. As it is this time, it is this year going forward, kingdom will never be fought by people of religion. People of flesh and blood can never fight against the kingdoms. Kingdom must be against the other kingdom. If we see the invasion of this nation, to be particular, the nation being invaded by drugs, the nation being invaded by liquor, which is alcohol, there is something that we need as the church. There must be an invasion about the Bible, preaching the Holy Bible to the people in the streets, in the towns, in tents, in everywhere where we are. Then, I'm saying, being religiously is helpless at times like this. Being carnal, because the Bible says those who are carnal can never please God. So if you are carnal, please change your mind. Change your mind. Authority is in the church. Government is in the church, not in politicians. Politicians are taking chance because the church is silent. Silence will make more people to go to hell. Once the church becomes so silent as it is now, we need to blow out the trumpet. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Being the church of Christ, we need one thing. We need one thing to understand the kingdom. Secondly, noba siyathandaza masithandaze sisebukumkanini. Ubukumkani abuliwa ngecawa. Ubukumkani bulwa ngobunye ubukumkani. And the Bible, Daniel, is claiming that the kingdom of heaven or the kingdom of God is powerful and it reigns forever. Psalms 103 verse 19, the kingdom of God rules forever. Psalms 145 verse 13, the kingdom of God rules forever. It has no end. Revelation chapter 11 verse 15, and all the kingdoms of this world are for the Lord and his Christ. Who is his Christ? It's me and you. If you are in Christ, then we are having the responsibility to denounce the kingdoms of darkness. To denounce means to fight against them, to dethrone them. Yeah, we must dethrone the thrones of the devil. If we are not in the kingdom, then it's obviously we're gonna lose. Saints of the Most High, please, coming together is the better option, is the better solution for now. Working together so that we can take out every satanic force in this generation. The Bible says, Acts 17 verse 6, and these have turned the world upside down, and they have come here for to do so. So, here's one thing. At the early church, they never ask for a permission to preach in a place. It's one thing that we must know. If we ask to politicians, most of them are in Satanism. So if they are in Satanism, obviously, they will not permit. So we ought to enforce Psalms 24 verse 1, the earth is for the Lord is, so, and its fulfillment. So obviously, we ought to enforce, the church must enforce itself. But enforcing without prayer, you will be shot to death. Omnye will be arrested. We must pray, win the cities in prayer, win the nation in prayer, win the world in prayer. Long prayers, cooperate prayer. When the intercessors will ask the Holy Spirit to baptize them in the kingdom of heaven, where the truth is, where the power is. Because the power of this generation depends upon knowing the truth about the kingdom of God. I know saints mostly have been preached in religion, have the mind of religion, not the relationship with the Father. May the Holy Spirit deliver those who are religious mindset, who claim to be saved, and yet God don't know them. So here's the solution. Let us ask the Spirit of the living God, who is here to help us, who is here to be our comforter. May we ask him to baptize us by the power of the kingdom of God, where the true power is, where the true power of this season is, because this is the season of the kingdom. Even if you check worldwide, when we see wars, it's the kingdoms versus the kingdoms. Believe by the help of the Holy Ghost, soon again I will come and reveal this thing of the kingdom. Kingdom of heaven, kingdom of God. These are the needy message to be understood, so that when we pray, we are covered by the garment of the kingdom of God, where the power is. Who can fight against God and win? No one. God is a creator, so we ought to seek his kingdom first. Rise up, dust off your laziness, go back to prayer, and go back to preach the gospel of the kingdom. The time is against us. Let us take the authority back as Jesus proclaimed. Matthew 28, verse number 18. He proclaimed that the authority in heaven, also on earth, is given unto him. So, as we are his church on earth, God depends on us. The Bible says,
Whatever I bind on earth, it is bound also in heaven. Whatever I loose on earth, it will be loose on heaven also. So there are things, not material things, but spiritual matters that we must seek before God. God is able, your Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20, is able to do all, even above exceedingly, according to the power that works in us. So the power is available to save sinners. The grace is available to save sinners, to pray, to fast, to break forth the end time revival. But let us go and pay the price, so that we cannot just blow, then we stop, blow, then we stop. We must blow until Jesus comes. That's what Jesus says, that, behold, I am with you till the end of the world. So your Great Commission, it's a must assignment. It's a must assignment until we take arms up and go forward with the gospel. This is the only solution of the world, where we will speak more about his kingdom, the kingdom of God, in order to dethrone the other religion. That's what the Bible says. The mountain of the Lord will be exalted above all the mountains in the end of time. What is that mountain? The church of Jesus. That time is now. It's not tomorrow. It's not next year. But it is now, where the mountain of the Lord, which is the church of the Lord, must be exalted and be lifted above. The Bible says they will not anymore lift their hands against each other. When the church has preached the kingdom. So saints, UN will not help. United Nations Organization will not help the world. A political organization will not help South Africa. Who will help South Africa is the church of South Africa, when it has understood, when the church understands that time is now to take authority, to take government, to take dominion, according to Genesis 1 verse 26, not to put the responsibility upon the politicians. One thing that I have noticed, in the town where I am, yeah, there are gangsters who are stabbing people, who are shooting, who are killing. But one thing that the Lord has helped us with is this. We are moving from town to town, preaching the gospel of the kingdom. Now, as we preach, the rate of gangsterism is going down, going down, going down. That is the sign that there is a demonic force which is pushing them to shoot, which is pushing them to kill. So if the church can rise an arm, hand, Lord, we surrender, we have no power, we have messed up, we have not done well, we need our authority back, we will preach the gospel, God is able. So let us just, saints, be not lazy, because laziness has made crime to look so powerful, has made people to feel so threatened. When they hear gunshots, they are threatened. Where is the church? Where is the church? Authority, dominion, power to rule this earth is in the church. It's not in the politicians. Let me close and see you next time, when the Holy Ghost permit me to see you again. Wherever you are, if you are a believer, you have a personal responsibility, not money, not anything, but to let this book, the Bible, to spread as the wildfire. Please, don't be lazy. Don't be lazy. I know you are not called to preach. Then pray. Souls must be won. Through your prayers, you must win souls. I know you are not a prayer warrior, then you are a preacher. Go and preach. Don't say, I'm waiting for the voice of the Lord. Saints, command says, go ye and make disciples of all nations. Government must be won back to God. Every nation, every person on earth must hear the gospel
of the kingdom, not eloquence, not deception. Do your assignment before it's too late. Goodbye.